We welcome you to today's live stream broadcast. Today we will be talking about the Passover, as it's the Passover week, and we hope you enjoy today's broadcast.
The Passover is one of the seven feasts celebrated by the Jews, and these feasts were given by God to the nation of Israel. And each of these feasts have different meanings. Today we are looking at the Passover and its significance. The Passover starts when the Jews, when they were captive in the nation of Egypt, and Moses, liberator, went up to Pharaoh and told Pharaoh to let his people go. There were several trials that came on the nation of Egypt, the final being the death of the eldest son. Now, during the Passover, there are certain things that the Israelites were asked to do. Moses told the people of Israel to get ready to escape from Egypt and to go to the promised land. So each family had to prepare for themselves, get ready to escape from Egypt and go. And thus the Passover meal was held. Now this Passover meal had certain characteristics and there were reasons. For example, the bread that is prepared for the Passover meal does not have any yeast. Now, the simple reason why they don't have yeast is because if you know about baking, you know that you leave the dough to rise. Now, the people of Israel, when they escaped from Egypt, they didn't have time for the dough to rise. So, they have to make bread without it rising. So, they have yeastless bread. And they had to eat some vegetables. Now they were asked to use bitter herbs. There again I'll explain it later on why bitter herbs. And then of course they had the lamb that was roasted for the part of the meal. All this has certain significance meaning behind it. As well, the urgency of getting ready to the meal, because this is the last meal they were going to have until they went to the promised land. So, what Moses was expecting was people to eat and then quickly go out and then go into the promised land. So, what we are doing today, we are going to look at what the Israelites would have been doing at the last meal or the last supper before they left Egypt. It's also known as the Passover meal. We'll be looking at the significance of some of these activities and their relevance for today. The first part of the Passover is to cleaning yourselves. Traditionally, there was a part where you wash your hands and you prepare for the Passover meal. So that is done by the head of the house, but also the people had to freshen up, had to clean themselves and come beforehand. The meal starts with the eating of the bitter herbs. Now, bitter herbs actually represent the hardship the Israelites had to undergo in the nation of Egypt. And before you eat it, the bitter herbs are dipped in salt water for purification. So it was a symbol of purifying the harshness and you consume it. Now, partaking of the bread. Now, remember this is a meal. So therefore there are many loaves of bread which is prepared. And from the pile of bread, the middle one is taken and it's broken in half. One half is put back into the pile. The other half is wrapped in a piece of cloth and kept away for later. Now, during this time, the children in the house would ask questions.
Is night different from all other nights?
On all other nights, we eat either bread or matzah. On this night, why only matzah? On all other nights, we eat herbs or vegetables of any kind. On this night, why bitter herbs? On all other nights, we do not dip even once. On this night, why do we dip twice? On all other nights, we eat our meals in any manner. On this night, why do we sit around the table together in a reclining position?
These are the answers to the children's questions. We were slaves to Pharaoh in Egypt.
And God brought us out of
the strong hand
and outstretched arm.
And
if God had not brought our ancestors out of Egypt, we and our children and our children's children would still be subject
to Pharaoh in Egypt. Even if you all
old
and learn
the Torah,
you would still
commanded
to tell the story
of the Exodus
from
Egypt.
And the more
we talk
about
the Exodus
from
Egypt,
the
more
praiseworthy
we are.
Also, me was another occasion when the senior people of the family told the children of what took place in Egypt, how they came out of Egypt. And explaining what this Passover is all about. Now, the lamb in the Passover meal actually comes from the lamb was slain. Now, Moses commanded all the Israelites to kill a young lamb, unblemished lamb, take the blood and put it on the doorpost of each house. Now, this was a sign for the angel of death that this house is being protected by God, and for the angel of death it cannot go into this house. Whichever house that didn't have the marking of the blood, the eldest child was killed by the angel of death. So the meat that came from the slaying of the lamb was cooked or was roasted. And this was a part of the meal. So that is where you find lamb on the table of the Last Supper in Egypt for the Passover meal. Blessed are you, Lord God, King of the universe, who creates the fruit of the vine. And then each one takes the wine. When the bread is eaten, a blessing is said. This blessing goes like this. Blessed are you, Lord God, King of the universe, who brings bread from the earth. Now remember, at the beginning, one loaf of bread was broken into two, and half of it was covered in a piece of cloth and kept aside. Once the meal is over, the children have to go around looking for this piece of bread which was hidden, and then they find it and they bring it out. This you can say it as a dessert for the meal. It's, they call this the Epicomen. I said this Passover meal has a lot of meaning behind it. The meaning behind this Epicomen or the half of loaf of bread, which is in, is actually symbolizing Jesus' resurrection. It was in, so it was actually prophesied long before even Isaiah. During the Passover itself, the resurrection of Christ was foretold by this. What I have explained to you is only part of all the rituals they do in the Passover according to Moses' teachings. Just to give you an understanding of what Passover is. Now, to the church now, this Passover doesn't have the same significance it has for the Israelites. For us, because we have a new covenant with Jesus, and that covenant was what he did at the Last Supper. But you can see a lot of similarities from there to what we do now, because even Jesus himself celebrated Passover with his disciples. That is what was doing in the upper room. So this feast was celebrated by Jesus. So significance is there. We need to understand why he was doing that.
Thank you for watching today's broadcast, guys. And in conclusion, I would just like to say, even as you know, today the Jews celebrate the Passover to remember how the Lord delivered them out of the sufferings they had to undergo in Egypt and took them to the promised land. Likewise, we as Christians, we serve the same God that they served thousands of years ago, and He is there to protect us, to deliver us. And so during this Passover season, let us keep that in mind, and especially as these days there is so much chaos in the world, so much turmoil in the world, especially with this coronavirus and this pandemic. So today, let us remember, we have a God who protects us, and we can look to Him and call to Him, and He helps us. And even in the midst of this curfew, I'm sure many of us have, and as you all would have seen the last few days, we broadcast some of those testimonies on live stream, and there are many others who have told, and we ourselves have personally experienced the Lord's protection, the Lord's provision at this time. And actually, just a day or two ago, I was talking with a friend of mine. She and her husband pastor a small church in Killapana, and most of the people in that church are daily wage earners. And when it was curfew, many of them didn't have any money because they are daily wage earners, and they didn't have food to eat. And they have been calling and telling her, and she is in Moratuwa, and she also had no way of helping them at that point with the curfew and all that. So she had just told them, pray to God, look to God, He will provide. And some of them had wonderful testimonies of the Lord's provision. One family, first they were saying they have nothing to eat, and then she told them, look to the Lord, pray to the Lord. And then when they started praying to the Lord, suddenly a truck arrived in their area, and the truck was distributing free parcels, and they were also given a parcel, and the parcel had 10 kilos of rice and so many other things. And the Lord provided in an amazing way for that poor family. So even today, the Lord is there as our protector, as our provider, even as He protected the children of Israel. When the angel of death went past, the angel of death didn't come coming to the houses of the Israelite children. The Israelites were protected. When the angel of death saw the blood smeared on their doorposts, he went past their houses. Likewise, today the blood of Jesus protects us from pandemics, pestilences, from all dangers. We have protection through the blood of Jesus. So tune in tomorrow as we listen to testimony by a patient who had coronavirus and was healed of coronavirus tomorrow at 11 a.m.